Okay, so a very good morning to all of you, those who are watching this video. Children, we are going to start Microsoft Word 2010. As we have discussed this in our online classes as well, I am going to give you a brief in this video. What is Microsoft Word first? Microsoft Word is a word processing software. So, as we write in notebooks, if we have to write something, we take a piece of paper or we write in a notebook. Same way, we need some softwares to write in computer as well. We cannot write directly on desktop. Yes, we can't. So, we need some software. So, there are many software like WordPad, Microsoft Word, even in Paint we can write. So today the software which we are going to discuss is Microsoft Word. That is a word processing software in which we can type, edit, and format our text. These are the 10 points that we are going to discuss today. First is starting the Microsoft Word. How we can start it? You can see already on my screen I have opened a Microsoft Word only. Yes, now I'll tell you from starting how we have to start. Now, check my cursor is moving to start button now here, and this dialog box appears. Then you have to go to all programs, and from all programs, you have to look for Microsoft Office. And once you click on Microsoft Office, you will have all options of Microsoft Office. Now, here is the Word. Once you click it will open a new document. Right, it's already there, so I have not clicked. This is how to open. Now, what are the main components of it? So, see the top bar where it is written Class 3, Chapter 7, Microsoft Word. That is title bar, right? And the left side of that where the save, undo, and redo buttons are there. These are quick access toolbar tools. That tools which we use very frequently, that comes here. We can even add more in it, right? And then down this where it is clipboard, font, paragraph. These are the groups of commands. And this hole is called a ribbon, right? This hole is called a ribbon. And then we have a ruler here, see at the top, this one where 1, 2, 3 is written, this is called a ruler. And you have a scale, same way this is a ruler. And the side ones, you can see here I'm moving my page, I'm going to first and then moving down. So this is called a scroll bar, which helps us to scroll our screen. And the last, not the least, is the working area where we are typing. The white area where we type is called a working area. These all components are given in a diagram, figure number 7.2 on your page number 69. So you all can check these, right? So that you can remember it. Then after that we have how to create a new document. Now this document is already open. If you want to create a new one, what you will do? You will go, you must be having a file option in your systems and or this button. So you'll go here or file option and then you'll go to new. Once you'll click on new, you will have a dialog box like this, and then you have to click on blank document and click create. Now you can see a blank document is there. Yes. And how to write in this? I have already told you, it's very simple. You just have to start typing from your keyboard. As I have explained you in class, how to write a birthday invitation. Yes. Same way. You can write, you can format it. I'm selecting it. Going to the color option, giving it some color, changing the font size, and this how we can write, edit, and format. Suppose I have written something wrong here, I have missed the N or I have missed the A here. So what I can do, I can simply click there in between and write. It's not that we need to, like if we have written on a notebook with a pen, it's very difficult to give the to do the cuttings and all. So these softwares make the editing very easy. Okay, so I'm closing this one now and moving back to my previous document. Now this entering text, I told you how to enter. Now selecting, something you have to change. Suppose I have written this in purple color, but I want to change it. So you will select it first. How to select? Whatever you want to select, put your cursor and drag it. Press the left mouse button and drag it. This how we can select, and then whatever you want to apply, you can apply. So now I see, if I'll change it to some other color, here suppose black, so it's black now. Okay, this is how selecting the text. Then is saving a document. This document is already saved, but still I show you how to save it. You'll again go to file option and go to save as, for the first time if you're saving it. And then this dialog box will appear. Now I want to save it. Anywhere you can save it, wherever you want. Fine. Suppose I want to save it on desktop only. So I'm saving it here on desktop. And I'm giving it name class 3, chapter 7, Microsoft Word. Right. And click save button. Now this is, we have saved. Now I'll show you where it is. But first I'll tell you, after this we have a close option, that how to close the document. There is one option very simple, that you have to simply go to the cross button at the top of the title bar, right hand side, there is a close option. You can close it from here. The other option is, you have to go to the file option again, or there is one option close. You can see here, close is there. So if we'll close it, see. So Word software is there, but only your document has gone, but the main screen is still there. Yes, it is there. Okay, so this how it closes only the document which you are using. Then if you again want to open it, or you want to open any other document which you have saved, so what you will do, you will again go to file option, you'll go to open, and then in open you have to search where you have saved. Suppose here I have saved on desktop, so I am looking for my option. So here it is. So class 3, chapter 7. Yes, and I'm going to click, select it and open it here. So same document is back. I'll just show you on desktop also, once minimize it. Yes, here is the document. See, this is the document. Class 3, chapter 7. Fine. So this how we have opened it. Now there is one more option to exit. How to exit it? Now there is a difference between a close and exit. Once we have done the close, only this document where we are working has gone, but the Microsoft Word software was still opened. Window was still there. Yes. But exit, if we'll go for exit, it will completely close the whole software only. I'll just show you. See on file again I'm going, and here it is my exit. You can find it here also somewhere, because from version to version there are little changes also. So I'm exiting from here. See, I'm back on my desktop, right? So I'll open it from here again. So I hope you got it, the difference between close and exit. Yes. So the last option of this chapter, that is how to print a document. So you all are very smart kids, I know you must be knowing it, but as it's in our syllabus, so I'll tell you. Oh, it got closed. Let me open it again. Okay, so we are here. So how to take a print. So if you'll go to file again and you go to print, you'll get a print preview option. You'll go to print preview, and then it will show you that how your print will come, and these are the options. Somewhere these option comes here in a left pane also, because this is a version 2007, and when I was showing you in the online class, I was having an upgraded version. So there are little slight changes in every version, but otherwise the options and the functions are almost same. So this is how it shows. If you want to make little changes to it, you can change it. If you feel like something is not coming appropriate, you can go back, close the view, change it, and then you can give the print command. So this all we have covered for the chapter number 7. And as I have given you activity also for the birthday invitation, I hope you all have done it. Yes, so next time in online class, we'll check. Fine? So thank you so much, children. This is all for today class.